10 rounds.
How was it? Oh, it's just through one hole. And all the BBs broke.
Wow.
Hey, what's up guys? This is Andrew Lai from Quad. You know, we deal with airsoft BBs quite often. However that, we're doing something really different today. We're balling today! Woo! And that was inconsistent. So guess what? For today's episode, it's gonna be the shooting speed and consistency test.
Talking about shooting speed and consistency, velocity may be the first thing that we think about, and obviously the joules. However that the joules are so huge, we're just gonna make another complete episode for it, so stay tuned. Let's start with shooting speed consistency. In definition, what is consistency? Briefly speaking, under the system, the quality of behavior or performance always keeps the similar way. Say if our movement of throwing the bowling ball is always the same, then this way we say the platform is consistent. In the other hand, if the movement is constantly changing, and yet giving a different result, then we say it's inconsistent. Okay, now let's take this subject back to airsoft. What is consistency? Guns are actually like this repeating functional system in which it repeats its own action over and over again. So by using a specific BB weight, if the velocity output is stable without too much of a difference, then we will say the gun is shooting consistently. However, if every shot has a dramatic velocity change in FPS, then this way we will call it inconsistent. Speaking of here, we could say that consistency equals to predictability. And if a certain gun is shooting consistently, then its trajectory is much more predictable.
Or is it?
I don't know, maybe. You know what? That is actually a really good one for another episode. Let me write it down.
And how do we score it?
Alright, here it goes. Here's the fun part, the scoring. The score is quite simple. We will measure the first 10 shots of our test subject, for this case, the SIG 552. And out of the 10 shots, we will use the maximum velocity minus the minimum velocity. Say if the number is really high, then that means the gun is much more inconsistent, and the lower score it will receive. Let's finish the grading system test for the SIG 552. If you haven't seen the really cool videos that we made, make sure you click the link right below. Check out the good stuff we made. Click it, like it, love it, subscribe it, and don't forget to ring it. Alright folks, here's the brilliant plan. Basically, we got the gun set up with the clamp, clamped in place, and we got the chrono right here. Obviously, when the BB shoots through, you get to see the numbers. And this is the BB catcher. Well, it catches the BB for us. We love BB catchers, why not, right? And we got three cameras set up, actually four. Brendan, he's got one in his hand. The Canon right here, the Sony for the slow motion, and then also the GoPro at the back. So this way, you kind of get an idea what happens for 360 degree for the shooting speed consistency test. We're testing the 0.2 grams first. Always the 0.2 grams. You guys ready?
Ready.
All right, in three, two, one, go. All right, that's 10 shots. Let's take a look at the result. From the slow motion, we can see the BBs are badly crushed after hitting the BB catcher wall. Luckily, all the debris are kept inside instead of everywhere.
It seems like the maximum is 121 and the minimum it's 116.5.
So in math, that's
-4.5. I'm really bad at math, I'm sorry.
But back in the bowling game, something actually really bugs me. I see Brendan's striking performance is not really affected by the weight of the ball.
No!
And so do I. No matter what weight of the ball I use, it constantly goes to the side. And so do some. Will this be the same for airsoft?
Okay guys, we just completed the 0.2 gram shooting speed consistency test. And we got all these BBs right here prepared from the 0.23 all the way to 0.4 gram, as we know that the SIG 552 is capable of firing up to 0.4 grams. So yeah, for this case, we want to find out like if different weights of BBs would actually affect the shooting speed consistency. Maybe the heavier will be more consistent and the lighter wouldn't be as much. Let's test it out. Here, we shot 10 shots to the chrono from 0.2 gram up to 0.4 gram. So based on the result, we can see that even by switching to different weights of BBs, when we minus the maximum velocity to the minimum velocity, we still don't see that much of a difference. In conclusion, the ICS SIG 552 is receiving a 6 points for the shooting speed and consistency test. Not so good, but not so bad. Thank you guys for watching this episode. We hope you loved it. And leave some comments down below. We would love to know your opinion. What's the cost for an airsoft gun to shoot unstable? Let us know. We would love to find out. We will see you soon.
Hey, Brendan. I think we're missing something.
What is it?
It's...